blind man. In a small village, there was a man named Samuel. He couldn't see anything. Samuel's life was very sad. Every day, he woke up to darkness. He felt lost in a world he couldn't see. In the mornings, it was quiet. There were no birds singing or sunlight shining. Samuel felt alone. He heard only his own breath. It made him feel lonely. Samuel couldn't see colors. He couldn't see the blue sky, the green grass, or the pretty flowers. He missed out on the beauty of the world. It left him feeling empty inside. His days were spent without sight. Samuel relied on his other senses. He touched things to know where he was. He moved slowly, feeling his way through the world. He couldn't see the things around him. Samuel had a garden. He couldn't see the flowers, but he touched them gently. He listened to the sounds of nature. It helped him imagine the colors that surrounded him. The people in the village knew Samuel. They felt sorry for him. Sometimes they helped him. They described things to him. They told him about the colors and the beauty of the world. Samuel listened and tried to imagine. At night, when it was dark, Samuel sat by his window. He listened to the sounds outside. He heard people talking and animals making noise, but he couldn't see their faces or expressions. He felt disconnected from the world. Samuel's heart longed for the things he couldn't see. He wanted to see people's smiles and their happiness. He wanted to see the sunrise and the stars at night. But all he had was darkness. Even with his sadness, Samuel didn't lose hope. He found comfort in the kindness of others. He felt loved by his friends and family. They described the world to him. Samuel was grateful for their help. In his quiet moments, Samuel dreamed of seeing. He imagined a miracle that would give him sight. He hoped for a day when he could see the beauty of the world. Until then, he held on to his dreams and faced each day with strength. In the small village, something exciting happened. Doctors and scientists came with a special device that could maybe help Samuel see again. Everyone was hopeful. Samuel sat in a chair, waiting for the doctors. The room was filled with excitement and hope. The doctors explained the procedure to Samuel in simple words. Carefully, the doctors put the device on Samuel's eyes. It felt strange, but he stayed hopeful. People watched, waiting for a miracle to happen. The device made a soft sound, and Samuel felt a tingle. Suddenly, a little light appeared. It was faint, but he could see it. Samuel felt joy in his heart. The doctors told Samuel to open his eyes. He did. Slowly, the world came into view. A bit blurry at first, but then clearer. People were amazed watching this miracle. Samuel could see colors for the first time. He saw the red of a rose, the green of trees, and the golden sun. Tears came to his eyes. It was beautiful. The villagers cheered and clapped. They were happy for Samuel. They described things to him, pointing out objects and colors. Samuel listened carefully, trying to connect their words with what he saw. As days passed, Samuel's sight improved. He could recognize shapes and faces. The world wasn't a mystery anymore. It was full of colors and shapes he could finally understand. Samuel went outside and explored the village. He saw the details of buildings, the busy marketplace, and people's smiles. It was wonderful, a celebration of life. But along with the happiness, Samuel felt a bit sad. He had lived his whole life without sight. Now he had to get used to this new way of seeing. He had to learn how to do things with his eyes. There were challenges. It was hard to judge distances, and he sometimes bumped into things. Samuel had to relearn simple tasks like pouring water or walking on a crowded street. It was a process, but he didn't give up. Despite the difficulties, Samuel loved his new sight. He enjoyed the beauty of nature, watching the sunrise and sunset. He loved seeing people's expressions and emotions. The villagers supported Samuel. They helped him adjust to this new life. They understood his challenges and were kind to him. Samuel was thankful for their help and felt lucky to have them. Time went by, and Samuel's sight became a normal part of his life. He didn't only rely on his other senses anymore, but he embraced his gift of vision. His life changed, and he inspired others with his story. After Samuel regained his sight, life seemed full of possibilities. But something unexpected awaited him, something that would change everything. As Samuel explored the village with his newfound sight, he noticed an old house hidden away. It seemed mysterious, with boarded-up windows and an eerie silence. Samuel's curiosity grew. He cautiously entered the house, stepping into darkness. As he moved through the rooms, he discovered drawings and symbols on the walls, telling a story of darkness and despair. They seemed strangely familiar. Samuel's mind filled with questions. Who had created these drawings? What was their meaning? He felt a deep connection, sensing they held the key to his own past. Driven by curiosity, Samuel investigated further. He discovered an old diary hidden beneath the floorboards. Its pages revealed a dark secret, a secret tied to his own journey. The diary belonged to a blind man who had lived in the house before Samuel. He had possessed a special gift, one that allowed him to see a different world, a world filled with darkness. Samuel realized he inherited this gift. With a heavy heart, Samuel understood that his newfound sight was not a miracle, but a curse. The colorful world he had embraced was tainted by the darkness he couldn't escape. In a brave decision, Samuel chose to sacrifice his sight willingly. He knew that only by doing so could he break the cycle of despair that haunted the house and find peace. In the dead of night, Samuel returned to the old house. He closed his eyes, whispered a silent prayer, and let go of his vision. Darkness enveloped him once again, but this time it brought a sense of relief. As the sun rose the next morning, the villagers discovered Samuel's lifeless body in the house. Sorrow filled their hearts, but they understood the depth of his sacrifice. Samuel's story became a legend in the village, a reminder of the power of selflessness and the price one might pay for the pursuit of truth. The old house stood as a silent testament to his sacrifice, its secrets forever hidden. The villagers carried Samuel's memory in their hearts, cherishing the lessons he taught them. They appreciated the beauty of their own lives and the importance of selfless acts of love. And so, in that small village, Samuel's story became a reminder of the strength of the human spirit and the sacrifices we are willing to make for the greater good. His legacy would live on, inspiring generations to come.